retribution manifested by...
So Scott James, boxing out of Fister. One fight in his career so far. Two fights between them, these two. Interesting choice of tune to come into, if you caught the kind of intro to it there. I'm not sure that would survive on mainstream TV. I think people might have a word. But one fight, one defeat for him so far. Made his debut just 9 days ago, actually, in Savoy. Lost some points to Josh Ejekpovi. Good fight to Ejekpovi, 8-0. Picked up a lot of good experience when he was an amateur. Been over to the Mayweather gym, actually, during the summer. With his stablemate, Sydney Byfield. So that's the only outing for James so far. So Carl Hawes, 31 years old from Witten, one fight, one win. Ah, now, this is a choice of ring walk tune. Yeah. Bit of Vinnie Camosi, here comes a hot stepper. Reminds you of the Prince back in the day.
All the crowd on their feet. He sold some tickets, this boy.
He must have done. Whatever people say about Nassim Hamed, and there are plenty of opinions, the one thing you cannot deny, apart from his fighting ability inside the ring, is that he brought the level of razzmatazz to ring walk, to boxing in general, which I'm not sure we've seen before, and I'm not sure we've seen since.
And always had a great ring song as well, didn't he?
So here we go, final fight of the night. Four rounds between Carl Hawes and Scott James. Hawes in the white shorts. He has sold a lot of tickets. He's got some decent sponsors as well by the look of those shorts. James, well, he's here all alone, really. He's come out on the front foot, though. He's come to have a go, certainly. Caught a stiff jab on his way in, but came back throwing. And this could be an interesting final fight, I think. These two going at it right from the start. Need to get that jab working, Hawes, I think. It looks like it's a decent one. Good left hand there from James. Caught Hawes high on the head. Trying to push out that jab, trying to snap out that jab, Hawes, but James really is just walking straight through it. He's not bothered about the amount of tickets that Carl Hawes has sold. He's not bothered about how expensive his shorts look or anything like that. He's coming to have a crack and win this fight.
I think he wishes he was on his way back up the motorway by now. I think he looks upset. He's definitely come to have a go. good opening round.
Good for the right hand there, Horse, and found a home for it to a degree, but James had covered up, and then just before the referee said break, he left himself a bit open there, Horse, and he was open for the uppercut there too, and it landed from James, but not quite flush. Just standing on the ropes here, James, and Horse looking to try and step in. Left hand off the ropes there from James as Horse was trying to pressure him, back him up. Nice right hand there from Horse. And these two just throwing leather. They have done right from the very, very start of the fight, and they're not putting an awful lot of thought or design into this at times, but it's good to watch.
Well, they throw more punches in this first round than there was in the last fight altogether. Unbelievable.
Well, good first round. Good entertaining first round. This final fight of the night. Plenty of stake because Horse has sold plenty of tickets. It's always a bit of an old promoter's trick, isn't it? If you've got a big ticket seller, you don't put them on early.
Always put them on last, don't you? Just keep the crowd there.
So into the second round, Karn Hawes in the blue and white, Scott James in the black, and it was a pretty even opening round. They both threw plenty. Wouldn't really like to have picked a winner in it, to be honest.
It's like you've pressed pause and they've started again.
Absolutely. Interesting. I find it hard to believe that James would have taken this approach against Jack Povey, because I've seen him a couple of times, and getting through four rounds with him fighting like this, I'd say would be unlikely. Horse are trying to make a little bit of space there, just give himself enough room to free up that right arm and whip it up the middle. Just caught there, I think, maybe James, as he was trying to work on the inside himself. Certainly the Horse supporters on the far side of the ring seem to like it. Horse just trying to maintain that gap, and I think that's what he needs to do. He needs to try and keep that distance, but he needs to use the jab if he's going to do that. Right hand from James, right hand though just answered back from Hawes, right to the body from James. At times, Pete, he looks capable, Horse, of using that jab and turning this into the kind of fight, the kind of distance that he needs it to be at, and then he just stops doing it.
Do you know what? It's a cracking little fight, though. They're non-stop throwing punches. I mean, they must have thrown 300-400 punches each already. Not much fault in it, but they're not non-stop punching.
Left hand from James, and a good right to the body. Another good right to the stomach as well there. He's had a good little spell there, James.
slowing down a little bit now, both of them.
Well, it was inevitable, really, I think, that it would do. Bell goes. Plenty of energy for these two. They knew where they were in the order, but they've had to hang around and wait a long, long time. So halfway through this, scheduled for four, the final fight of the night. So into the third. And he's bringing both of them to the centre of the ring here. James quickly across the centre, just flicks out the jab and catches Hawes high on the head. That's happened a few times. Just a little bit messy at the start of the third round. Good right hand there from James, though, short right hand, and then looking to bang to the body as he back hauls up to that neutral corner. Where are you going with the scoring on this so far? It's hard, isn't it?
I've got James in front.
Just trying to cock that right hand and throw it there, Hawes, but James just beat him to it and stuck a left on him before he could get it away. Good solid looking left hand again there from James, and then just pushing the shoulder in, and the corner just telling him to work. I think they felt that he got all slightly hurt with that and haven't quite realised it.
They're both definitely earning their money tonight. It's a tough fight.
The referee just warning James about trapping Hawes's arm and stopping him from working, and I think that might have been a final warning for it as well. And he's just lifting his arms there to make sure that the referee can't accuse him of it again. Looking to rip with the uppercut there, James. He didn't miss by a lot. Nice combination there from Hawes, and he's got James going here on the ropes, I think, and James just needs to lean in and hold on there, and then he throws a left hand, which was probably a little bit low, but he needed to do something to try and break up that flow of punches there from Hawes. He catches him high on the head again with the right hand, and he's got a bit of a problem here, James. All of a sudden, he's flat-footed, and just one more clean shot, I think, could do it for Hawes here. He looks for the uppercut, doesn't quite get it, but James O is just managing to hang in there.
He's coming back himself now, James.
Well, he had his back to us whilst all that was going on. He just looked like he was listing a bit, but maybe he wasn't quite as hurt as I thought. The bell goes at the end of the third round. So fourth and final round, touch of gloves between the two. Final round of action tonight from the Brentwood Centre. Pride and Glory brought to you on IFL TV in association with MTK Global. And this has been a good fight to finish with. Both of these two are just the one professional contest before tonight. Hawes won his, James lost his. James's was just 9 days ago in the rather grand surroundings of the Savoy. And they both really put everything into this. He had a strong finish to that third round, Hawes, which would have taken him that round. The first two rounds, well, not nearly so clear cut.
He looks stronger in this round as well, Hawes. James looks like he's getting a bit tired now. Bit still, more better movement.
Still trying to walk his man down. Looking for that right over the top there, Hawes. And then tries to stick out the jab. I haven't really seen him jab enough tonight. I think that's a tool he needs to try and sharpen up, because he has got reasonable reach there by the look of it. But James has managed just to bulldoze his way onto the inside a bit too easily, to be honest. Trying to measure that right hand as he was just chasing Hawes across the ring. It's a great thing being able to sell tickets, but it brings a bit of pressure with it too.
Especially when you've got a kid that comes to fight, and James has definitely come to fight tonight.
Right to the body there from Hawes was a decent shot, maybe just a slight slap, but landed. You could hear it from here. Mouth just hanging open there for James a bit. Looks to move away to his left hand side, but telegraphed that movement really. Hawes has outworked his opponent in the second half of this fight. Although James landed a solid looking right there and looks to try and get to work on the inside again. They're giving us full value, these two. We'll be getting itchy knuckles sitting backstage waiting for their opportunity. Might have thought it would have come a bit earlier than this, but most fights have gone the distance tonight. Just had a couple of stoppages. Nice right hand on the inside there from Hawes. Just clipped the chin of James. Now, the referee had only really just got in and said stop boxing, so you can understand why that was thrown by Hawes. And again, he's just warning James about holding on, and he's not going to take a point. I think if it happens again, he will. I don't think there's enough time left, really, for it to happen again. There goes the belt. Hawes and his supporters claiming victory at the end of the four rounds, and I would make them right. The second half of the fight was his, so really he only needs to get a share of one of those first two rounds or a win to take it. Not impossible, though, that James could be given those opening two. There was very little in either of them.
Good little fight, I wouldn't mind seeing that one again.
Yeah, it was decent. Just two pro fights between them before tonight. And James, as I say, made his debut just 9 days ago. So he's going to look to get out and box as often as he can. Hit the road, make some money.
I think James would give anyone a hard night.
They'll be called together in the centre of the ring very shortly for the final time tonight.
Deserve a draw here.
Our final contest. The score is as follows: 39-37. Your winner in the blue corner.
So Carnhorst gets it, 39-37, three rounds to one. I would agree with you there, to be honest, and the draw may well have been a fair result. Hawes, I thought, definitely took the third and the fourth, and he's obviously taken one of the first two rounds as well. But it was a tight fight, it was a good fight, and it won't have done Scott James any harm. He wanted the win, of course he did, but he showed exactly what he could do in there and what he brings. And there will be people picking up the phone to call him, I'm sure about that, to get him as an opponent, you would say, on their shows. Carnhorst, having shifted a lot of tickets, was under pressure to win, and he has got the win. Well, we'll be going over to Sofia for an interview with Carnhorst shortly, but it's been a good night, been a good enjoyable night, this MTK card on IFL TV. From the Brentwood Centre, we saw the return of David Price against Kamil Solikowski. There's work to be done, there's miles to be travelled yet before he gets back to the kind of level that he wants to be at. Impressive performances from Daniel Egbenike and a decent one from Dan Aziz as well. A quick win for Gary Sweeney. Tony Conquest back in the ring too after a couple of years away. So thanks very much for your company. And Carnhorst is making his way down to ringside. And so now for the final time tonight, Sophia, over to you.
My box on the back foot a bit more instead of trying to fight. Probably nicked me in the end. Thank you.
Again, a great learning fight for you going forward into next year.
Yeah, I thought I might have fought a few journeymen for my first three, four bouts. I've got a live fighter that's come to win, obviously, so that's good experience and just what I needed before Christmas, really.
And you pretty much got the entire arena as your support, and they were delighted with the win as well.
Yeah, I get a good support, good following, so that's why it's nice to fight local in Brentwood, because I can feel the place. It'd be nice to burn on a little bit earlier so I could see everyone, but don't get everything.
Oh, they've been loyal to you, they stayed right to the very end.
Definitely, I've got the best fans I could ask for, the best team around me, nutritionists, coaches. Probably all of that paid dividends near the end when I was struggling, to be honest.
And a great to end the year on a high.
Yeah, nice and a high. I got honeymoon with my missus at Christmas and then look forward to an early new year. Hey, brilliant, thank you.
Congratulations and enjoy the break. Well, that's it from us. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed a great night of boxing. MTK London's next show is back here March the 3rd, live on IFL TV. Until then, good night.